We can discuss about the different sterilization monitors which are used in sterilization process in this video. As we all know, the sterilization process are the process which are performed to complete destruction or removal of microorganism. And we are performing this sterilization process in a belief that after the sterilization process, all the microorganism will be killed or destroyed. But in order to assure that, we may have to use some controls, and we can use two type of controls, like control on process of sterilization, like sterilization monitors or sterilization indicator, which we will use along with the sterilization process, and after the sterilization process we will get a color change or any other result, and from that we can assure the complete sterilization process has been carried out. And also we can done by sterility testing process. In this, after the sterilization process, we have to take some sample from the sterilized product and we have to go for sterility testing by placing that sample in a suitable culture media, and we have to incubate for a specified time. If there is any presence of turbidity or presence of growth, it indicates the sterilization process was failure and it couldn't destroy all the microorganism, all the viable microorganism. So here we will discuss in detail about sterilization monitors which are used. Monitoring of sterilization process can be achieved by using physical indicator, chemical indicator, or by using biological indicators. We can discuss each one in detail. First one, physical indicator. Physical indicator which is used in moisture heat sterilization. So as a part of sterilization process, before or while installing a sterilizing equipment, we have to validate that equipment. This validation is to assure that the equipment is properly installed and is properly working and it is giving properly determined the result in further sterilization process also. As the part of this validation, a master process record is prepared, and this master process record is used as a reference for the process record obtained from single thermocouple placed in the strategic part of each load, and which will give a batch process record on each process. So we have to check this master process record at annual interval, and also whenever a significant change occur in batch process record when compared with the MPR or master process record. Micro process controlled sterilization cycle are now a part of modern autoclave, and the pressure is measured by pressure gauge or through pressure transducer. Now coming to physical indicator used in dry heat sterilization process. Here also, as the part of validation, we will prepare a master temperature record, and we will compare the temperature record chart which is made of each sterilization cycle, and we can monitor is there any change from a master temperature record and the batch temperature record chart. If there is any change in the temperature, we have to adjust that temperature and we have to control the sterilization process. Next one is physical indicator used for radiation sterilization process. Here, a plastic dosimeter which will give an accurate measure of radiation dose absorbed is used. And this is considered to be best technique currently available for the radiation sterilization process. Now coming to the physical indicator used in gaseous method or gaseous sterilization method. Here we will monitor elevated temperature in each sterilization cycle by temperature probes. Also at regular interval we will perform routine leak test in order to ensure gas tight seal, and also we have to measure the gas concentration independently of gas rise, often a reference with the weight of the gas used, and also pressure and humidity are measurement are recorded at regular interval in order to monitor the gaseous sterilization process. Next one is physical indicator used in filtration process. This is monitored by performing a bubble point pressure test. This technique is employed for determining the pore size of filter and also may be used to check the integrity of certain type of filter device immediately after the use. The principle of this test is the filter soaked in an appropriate fluid, and when pressure is applied to that filter, the pressure difference when the first bubble of air break away from the filter will be equivalent to the maximum pore size. When air pressure is further increased slowly, there is a general eruption of bubble over the entire surface. The pressure difference will be equivalent to the mean pore size. So that is the physical indicators used for the sterilization monitors. Now coming to the chemical indicators used for the monitoring of sterilization process. Chemical monitoring is based on the ability of heat, steam, sterilization gas and or ionizing radiation to alter a chemical or physical characteristic of a variety of chemical substances. And we can use Brown's tube, witness tube, heat sensitive tap, Roche sachets and chemical dosimeter as chemical indicators. First one is Brown's tube. This is most commonly used indicator in heat process. Brown's tube are small sealed tube containing a reaction mixture and an indicator. Exposure to high temperature complete the reaction and will produce a change in color of the indicator. And there are four type of Brown's tube and which will give a color change from red through yellow, brown and green, and the final color will be only achieved after a specified time at a given temperature. So these are the different Brown's tube, type 1, 2, 3 and 4. Type 1 will be used in moisture sterilization and it will give a black spot after reaching at 126 degrees Celsius for a specific time. And type 2 is used in high vacuum moisture heat sterilization and it will give an yellow spot at 130 degrees Celsius for a specified time. And type 3 is used in dry heat sterilization and it will give a green spot at 160 degrees Celsius for a specific time. And type 4 is used in dry heat infrared conveyors which will give a blue spot at 180 degrees Celsius if we are treating for a specified time. This is a picture of Brown's tube. Next chemical indicator is witness tube. This consists of a single crystalline substance of non-melting point contained in a glass tube like sulfur which will melt at 115 degrees Celsius, succinic anhydride which will melt at 120 degrees Celsius, benzoic acid which will melt at 121 degrees Celsius. A dye also can be included to show more clear that the crystal have been melted, so the color change will indicate a certain temperature have been reached. So this is a picture of witness tube. Now coming to the heat sensitive tap, which is used as a chemical indicator. It is used quantitatively in Bowie's stick test, and this test is to determine that all air have been removed from the dressing and the subsequent steam penetration have been even and rapid. This tap is placed suitably wrapped at center of a test pack. So after the sterilization process, all the bar on the tap should change color to demonstrate full penetration of steam. So that is heat sensitive tap. This is a picture of heat sensitive tap. Now coming to Roche sachets. This is a chemical indicator which is used for ethylene oxide sterilization and it consists of an polyethylene sachet containing magnesium chloride, HCl and bromophenol blue indicator. A given concentration time exposure to ethylene oxide result in the formation of ethylene chlorohydrin, which will change the color from yellow to purple. This is a picture of rosy sachet. Chemical dosimeter, which is used as a chemical indicator in radiation sterilization. So these are substances which will give an accurate measure of radiation dose absorbed and are considered to be one of the best technique currently available for monitoring the radiation sterilization process. Qualitative indicator made of radio sensitive chemical impregnated in plastic are also available, and the indicator will change a color from yellow to red during irradiation. So these are the different chemical indicators used for the sterilization monitors. Now coming to the final biological indicator used for the sterilization monitoring. The biological indicator consists of suitable bacterial spore which are genetically stable and readily characterizable, and non-pathogenic spore with high and reproducible resistance towards the sterilizing agent. And this indicator is deposited on carrier and distributed throughout the sterilization load. Now, at the end of the sterilization process, the units are recovered and cultured in suitable culture media and incubated to determine the presence or absence of survivor. So if there any presence of viable microorganism which will indicate as turbidity in the culture media, that indicate the presence of viable microorganism, that indicates the failure of sterilization process, because the sterilization process couldn't destroy all the source of this biological indicator. So these are the different biological indicators used for different sterilization process. For the sterilization process of autoclave at 121 degrees Celsius, Bacillus stereothermophilus spores has been used. Here the D value is 1.5 minutes. The D value is the time in minute which is required to reduce the number of viable microorganism by a percentage of 90. This means in 1.5 minutes, autoclave at 121 degrees Celsius can destroy or kill 90 of 100 Bacillus thermophilus. Now, biological indicators used in dry heat sterilization at 160 degrees Celsius is Clostridium sporogenes, and its D value is 0.8 minutes. And ethylene oxide at 600 milligram per liter, indicator is Bacillus subtilis or Wernicke. Ionization sterilization, biological indicator used is Bacillus spumilis, and membrane filtration sterilization process, biological indicator used is Serratia marescens, and membrane filtration at pore size of 0.22 micron spore is Pseudomonas daemonata. So this is a biological indicator which is available as ready-made strip. It is a frequently asked shortest answer question: biological indicators or sterilization monitors used in sterilization process. So hope it is clear. Thank you for watching this video.